morning.
Slowly and arm down. Opening your heart to what God's Spirit has to say to you today. Centering yourself in this place. The light God has placed deep within our hearts. We light the Christ candle. Remembering that we are made of light and love. Remembering that we are called to bring light and love to others and the world. We light the pride candle. Us to in this community of faith, we
presence of God. Here we seek to be inspired by the way of Jesus for the week ahead. Here we enter to look for ways to be transformed by the Holy Spirit.
Was, you know, tough, or have a little bit of anxiety.
tomorrow after the year.
Yes, soon as we're coming up.
I'm really thankful that we weren't as close to the fire as we could have been. I was so worried because I can't run easily. But our, we looked at the map, you know, they have the evacuation zone and then they have the state of emergency zone. Well, our house was like that much outside of the state of emergency zone. So we kind of wondered what was going to happen, especially when it was still so hot. And Sharon was able to set up our camper, and she was happy, letting us that 2 nights there. And I slept there for it, so I was really lucky for that. And I think she would be going to at least get some of our next 3 days. But we were actually in the danger. Can't imagine what people who are evacuated are going through.
I have two nephews and a niece that were evacuated from the homes in Daniel Flynn. Mm-hmm. And one of my nephews lost his home.
So sorry. Thank you.
it was like burning rubber, burning plastic. And I kept smelling it. And I said to myself, I think I'm having a seizure. Because I've never smelled anything like it before in my life. And I never equated that smell to fire. And I get in there and I'm smelling it like most of the day. And I'm like, yeah, I think I'm going to get a doctor's call. I think I'm having something is wrong with me. And then I go home and on Facebook, it says,
to get on the speaker.
Oh.
fellow humanity, fellow brothers and sisters in Christ, and any such humanity having to go through such a devastation.
We also need to just remember our sorrowing Adventure Church, yes, particularly St. Luke's Church in Cantal, and the Lord Reverend Rick, and all of our parishioners in the seriously affected there. And I know that our friends at Vox are doing some platform raising their costs for raising us all.
Yeah.
So, about the details, open our hearts to the overall message. Stir within us a zeal to live out your truth. We ask in the name of the one who taught us with authority, Jesus Christ. I read from John 16, 12 to 15. I still have many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them right now. When the Spirit of truth comes, He will guide you into all the truth, for he will not speak on his own, but he will speak whatever he hears, and he will declare to you the things that are to come. He will glorify me, because he will take what is mine and declare it to you. All that the Father has is mine. For this reason, I said that I will take what is mine and declare it.
May this offering inspired by you infused with the Holy Spirit enrich our journey. May the words of our mouth and the meditation of our hearts and be pleasing in the sight of God, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. It's highly believable that this time on last Sunday we were here and we were celebrating the metaphorical fire of Pentecost Sunday. And it's blowing through our ministry and blowing through our lives and clothing. And then we leave the church to literal fires that are products that are burning all week. It seems much longer than 7 days, as this past week has been a lot for many people. And I just wanted to hold on to that energy for a little bit longer. God as triune God, the Father or Mother, Jesus the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And in my mind, when I started, I thought, oh, I need to do one celebration that week. So then you want all the decorations. We're going to do this. But keeping on to the theme of fire this week, did not sit right with me. And I'm sure we've heard enough of it. Fire all the week long enough for a lifetime. During a crisis like this, or a tragedy, or a loss, someone often say, you know, how did this? Or ask the question, why did God do this to Nova Scotians? Why did God do this to so-and-so? Why did God take so-and-so home, or firm, or family pet, or horse? Well, my belief is that God did not do this. My God is a God of love. Not a God of tragedy or destruction or death. God does not look down on God's children like a computer game and move us around and put us in simulations just for something to do. God does not look at problems in Nova Scotia or other or the Ukraine and say, you know what, this is going too good for them down there. I think they need some challenges in their lives. Let me just add some fire, let me just add some war to show them who's in charge. Because my children need a little adversity or tragedy or crisis in their lives. God doesn't do that. I don't believe that my God, the triune God, the one I built my faith relationship with, the one I walk with, the one who I try to model my life after, is a God that creates crises and tragedies and losses. I just don't. The Trinitarian God that I believe in is a God of compassion and peace and mercy and comfort. And most importantly, love. Another question that gets posed to me sometimes, I love it, because they don't know what they're going to get when they hear it. Where is God in all of this? Right? Where is God in all of this? Well, I'm going to tell you, they're going to say, God is there. God is there in the midst of it. God is there guiding and protecting the first responders, the firefighters, the volunteers, the pilots, the animal control services. And the list can go on, the nurses, everybody, too many to name. God is there when the horses are set free from the blazing fire to find green pastures at the school to stay in until the dad arrives. And the list goes on. Jesus is there when families walk into comfort centers and stores and driveways where the generosity of thousands of people have been put on display so that those affected can feel cared for and not alone. Resources such as food, clothing, pet supplies, furniture, and so much more. Call that was answered over and over for cleats and clothing for an old boy to be able to play in a tournament with his friends as he lost everything. Jesus is there when those going towards the fire to land family, pets, and horses are standing between the fire to protect our own family are left unharmed. Due to the heroics. And then this goes on. The Holy Spirit is there when volunteers with trailers show up to help round up horses and bring them to safety. Offer them a stall to stay in and food to feed them until the owners are able to. The Holy Spirit those affected, to come and live with them, have a place to stay. When the Almighty God takes a back seat to compassion and love, as businesses such as Airbnbs and bed and breakfasts and hotels put up their own livelihood and put it on hold to help those in need. The Holy Spirit is there when gyms and fitness centers open up and offer free admission to give those impacted a place to come and mentally reset. Or when a mother invites complete strangers with her children to her daughter's birthday party just to give the parents a break for 2 hours to sit and cry. Or even go rent an ounce. The list goes on. God is there in the renewal of pets who have been reunited with their owners. I think a post I saw this week of Gertie and Renton as both captured by her. Has anybody heard of Gertie? Has anybody heard of Renton? Well, Gertie caught my heart. I'm going to tell you. She caught my heart. I told everybody about this weekend of Gertie, right? Her owner posts up this picture of her and his little Nina dog, hoping and praying for that one and only chance that she has. In her post, searching for Gertie, I saw pictures of Gertie living her best life. Look at her living her best life. The little life jacket on, climbing out on the water, or in on the swimming, doing something. And then another post is her laying back on the sofa, you know? Right? My heart broke for this unknown dog. My heart broke. And then all the whole company there saw the name of Gertie being found and reunited with her family. And the animal control services there making that happen. Gertie is alive and well with her family and all of the things. Same for Renton. The same for Renton. That is where God is, my friends. God, three in one, is in the thick of it, in the compassion, the caring, the providing, the helping, the guiding, the searching, the saving and the giving, and the rebuilding, and the restocking, and the relocating. God is there. God is in the law. It's not lost, I mean, today, that it's 3 days of break. Much needed break here in my church. And the Trinitarian in me, as I told you, loves a good three number, right? Everybody loves a good three. And the same we are grateful, as you just heard from Ryan, is an understanding. In a moment, I'm going to pass it over to Barb, who's going to sing a song by Anita Oster called Never Been So Grateful, that she shared with me this past week. And I ask you to listen to the words Barb sings, or you can watch them on the PowerPoint. God is here. God is always here. God the Father, Mother, Son, and Holy Spirit. And for that, we are all indeed
grateful on this journey. Amen.
We have gathered in the name of the one who moves around within us, the one who brings life to us as individuals and into this community, and the one who brings warmth, hope, and love. In gratitude for the one at work in our lives and every offering we have in this
evening. This is a song. You have come quiet voices. You missed a song. Yes.
We have gathered in the name of the one who moves around us and within us, the one who breathes life into us as individuals and into this community, and the one who brings warmth, hope, and love, and gratitude for the one that worked in our lives and the one that offered and that we achieved.
What can I say? What can I do? God the Spirit.
Let us offer ourselves and one another to the living God of Christ He taught us disciples and us to pray, because you are our mother and our father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come.
Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us.
Lead us not into
temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory,
forever and ever.
Amen.
As we said, the donation bin is located at the back of the church front, and we'd like to donate to fire relief, as well as Dale has an address for an enclosed that wants to go donated as well. I want to comment congregation know that Donald Wallace, a member of our church, has passed away. I've been in contact with his daughter Kathleen, and I've passed on our sympathies and our condolences on behalf of myself as well as the congregation. And our brief order was published this last week as well. Probably the conversation are here in the sanctuary after service. And our online auction letters are ready to be given out. And so they're available digitally or paper. We're in the process of uploading new items. So if you bring in new items, that would be great. And we'll keep you posted on that. Father's Day is coming up. And I'd like you to send your pictures in so that we can do a collage on all the fathers. And a huge thank you to DCW for all their support on our church and supper. Over $1,400 was raised in that center. That's very good. Mark the calendars as well on Sunday, June 25th, following worship service, there's going to be a congregational meeting. The purpose of this meeting is agreement regarding the changing of the structure of the Indigenous ministry within the United Church of Canada. Prior to this meeting, there are documents that will need to be read, because there are a lot, that's why I'm giving you guys a month's notice. There's a lot of documents that need to be read prior to the meeting. We will not be reading the documents here. We are going to come here for the meeting for any questions and discussion regarding the documents, and then a vote. So all the research will have to be done ahead of time by all of you. Links to view the documents are sent out in the weekly email, but Ryan has also created printed copies beside the copier as well for everybody who would like to grab some and take home with them. If you're not seeing our newest visual piece, please take a quick peek at the bulletin board that are by Ryan in my office. And it says, we can do hard things. That is my mantra for the last year, and I had that stuck in my head, and I said to Ryan, I really like to get that, somehow put in my office. And then Ryan came to me, but I have an idea, and I was like, well, what's your idea? Because I know my idea. And then we created, I will have to say, Ryan was it, so I'm really glad. So there's things on the side. If you're up to taking on a thing, then you're there, or if you want to create the thing, then you're there. Some are like social enterprises, a paint night, there's a barbecue, there's all kinds of different things that you can put up there. And when you do it, as you see, we already have two things over there. The turkey soup is over there, and the flea market is over there. So we have done our thing. So we're getting moving. But it's going to be nice to see some of those things at the end of the year move over. Some of the things have moved over and some following it, but they're all going to move. And any ideas that you have for fundraising or anything like that, or something for our church, like host an event, or to have guest speakers come in, anything like that, feel free to contact Ryan and put it up. Pass your name to it. They can do that very quickly. And then when it is done, you have the wonderful honor of moving that thing from planning to digits. Now, isn't that even such a feeling of accomplishment? Great job. So have a look at it. It's very easy. circle with Murray Kirby, who saw the addition on Ministries of Justice from out west. So that's really an amazing thing as well. So anybody who identifies as indigenous, are really welcome to come to that. Our closing here is great. Oh, I am worshiping today, everyone. Yes, let's. Anybody who's on worship team, we have a worship meeting today after our 12 o'clock. Just a matter of just in case you thought you were going to sit down after coffee. Alrighty. Praise our Maker of Worship today, number 16. Please stand as you are reading.
Thank you.